Welcome, friends. It's Friday night cocktail time for Mark. And if this isn't sad, it's Friday night, and I'm here talking to you about something as stupid as phonograph cartridges. A lot of you pretty much know, I think this is that's a Gelco. That's a Grado. That's a Techniques or a Panasonic. That one is as well. These two are Pickerings. And here is a Shure M97XE. These are all magnetic cartridges. They operate on a moving magnet that interrupts that creates an electric current into a coil of wire. This one is a ceramic cartridge, and so are these. All of these here are ceramic cartridges. Now, why is there a ceramic cartridge? Why is there a magnetic cartridge? First off, a magnetic cartridge, again, works quite differently. You will see that see if this autofocus on this cheap camera will work. See how that stylus cantilever is just sticking out there? You know, that is very freely able to accept the vibrations of the records. Magnetic cartridges, generally speaking, are very high compliance cartridges. They follow the groove of the record quite accurately. A ceramic cartridge, on the other hand, and I wait for the autofocus to pop in, there's a little fork there, a little saddle. Okay? It doesn't, and especially in the case of this A-Static here, this PowerPoint type, they are stiffer, and they don't follow the groove as well as a magnetic will. Okay, now, all that aside, I have for you an old A-Static 17D. These are ceramic elements within that cartridge. They work on a piezoelectric effect. The flexing of that piece of ceramic by the record groove, and because it's stereo too, they're both set at 45 degrees, the flexing of that ceramic element causes the generation of the electric current. They work much like a quartz crystal will. If it is pressed by a lot of force, it will generate an electric current. Now, these generate higher voltages than a magnetic will. Now, I know a lot of you guys have seen something like this. You can get them at Radio Shack. They have an input from that magnetic cartridge. They have an output. It also provides RIAA equalization. RIAA was that equalization curve was put into effect mainly because low frequency excursions of that groove would push that needle out of that groove really quickly. Anyway, this is called a preamplifier, of course. You see it right there. What this does is boost the voltage of a device like this, a magnetic cartridge, to an output that can be fed directly into a cassette deck, a reel-to-reel deck, whatever, even your CD line in, so on and so forth, and have that equalization to make the sound very natural. Now, suppose you wanted to have one of these hooked up to your turntable. Okay, you wanted a ceramic cartridge to connect to your phonograph. Well, can't do it. The higher output will overload your input stages. Yes, it is cocktail time, isn't it? This will overload your input stages. So what you need to do, make a little box like this. Well, not exactly like this, but similar to this. And I will show you what's inside this little baby. Okay, now I've removed all the screws. Well, some of them are tenacious, I'm not going to argue. What we see inside is a very complex circuit. No, it's not. What we have here are quarter watt resistors. These here, these are 47 kilo ohms. You can't really see it, but there is a yellow, a purple, an orange, and a gold band around those resistors. And that makes that 47,000 ohms. These here are red, gold. These are 2.2 kilo ohms. In other words, 2,200 ohms, okay, they go between the ground and the signal of the output output connectors. The input connectors are connected together by the 47,000 ohm resistors. Now, all these are grounded together by this wonderful aluminum plate on this Radio Shack project box. But what this will do, folks, is take the high-level input of a ceramic cartridge, reduce it to the level of a magnetic cartridge. But if you want to plug that into a modern stereo with magnetic cartridge inputs, go directly into that with this. If you need to connect your computer and record audio, you will need to go from that output to that input. Take that input and plug that into your PC, your Mac, whatever. And what that will do, again, you have a chain of events here. High level input reduced to magnetic level output. Take that magnetic level output, apply RIAA equalization, and output that into your CD line level input, tape deck level input, or your computer for audio recording software. And honestly, this thing works beautifully. So that's how you do it. Just a very simple box, a very simple circuit. Does not require any batteries or anything at all. You're just attenuating the level of that ceramic output to match the impedance of a magnetic level input. So there you have it. A very simple circuit, very easily done. A little bit of solder, a few pieces of Radio Shack, and there you have it.